Yes, if she were alive today, she'd be 45 years old, and she probably would be bringing her children, even her grandchildren, to the playground that now bears her name. Watch. A playground at the Sutton Rec Center in South LA now bears the name of the girl featured in this mural, Latasha Harlins. The 15-year-old was shot to death at a nearby market liquor store.
Today, 30 years ago, at about 9:10 o'clock in the morning, the police knocks at our door and tell us
that Harlins had been killed by the store owner. Grainy surveillance video shows a dispute over a bottle of orange juice at the Empire Liquor Store just before the woman behind the counter pulled out a weapon and shot the 15-year-old, killing her. Soon Jadu was found guilty of voluntary manslaughter, but sentenced to time served while awaiting for trial, a $500 fine, and community service.
She did not serve not one day in jail, but was sent home with probation only. This 15-year-old child who got her brains shot and blown out over a dispute over a bottle of orange juice was the precursor to the civil unrest in 92, after the jurors found the LAPD cops not guilty for beating Rodney King.
Activist Naji Ali with the family at the dedication of the playground Harlins used to play at.
Where we grew up at and where we played at oftentimes. So today is a remarkable day. It's like she turned 45 this year. A love song for Latasha was nominated.
A love song for Latasha was nominated for an Oscar in the Best Documentary Short Subject category. Netflix also sponsored the mural, which is up the street from where she died. A market now sits in the spot of that liquor store, but it can't sell liquor as the zoning was changed to prohibit it in this spot after Harlan's death. We run into a man who went to school with her.
I believe we have came a long way. You know, and you know, sometimes you still have, you know, the cop killings and stuff like that.
He is following jury selection in the trial of Derek Chauvin, the officer facing murder in the death of George Floyd. Everyone here is.
So I will be going to Minnesota supporting the activists and the leadership there, and hopefully they'll get justice for George Floyd being killed. Certainly, Latasha Harlins never got justice.
But at least today, her family rejoices.
Today, 30 years ago, at about 9:10 o'clock in the morning, the police knocks at our door and tell us. So it's just the community, I mean, the love that we receive from the community is unexplainable. Today, we just gonna just celebrate her legacy, her life.
And in that spirit, the Latasha Harlins Foundation, which helps young people from this particular community, is now active again. I'll put that information on our website at Fox LA. I'm Christina Gonzalez in South LA. Back to you in the studio.
A chapter so many of us remember well. Christina, of course, reporting during those days as well. Christina, thank you.